Hey everybody, it's Norm from Tested here on location. Now behind me are these massive tents for the Cirque du Soleil show, Volta. Now you might know Cirque du Soleil from their established shows in Las Vegas, but they also have a series of shows that travel around the world. They call them their big top shows. And for the past couple months, they've been performing their show Volta here in San Francisco. And that's closing in a couple weeks. They're gonna pack up this entire city of tents, the stage, the technical shops, the rehearsal spaces, onto a caravan of 74 trucks and move it down to San Jose and rebuild it in essentially 2 weeks to perform there. And before they do that, we're gonna go and talk with some of their technical staff about what they do to make this show run and make it work. Let's go take a look. So now I'm on the stage in the Big Ten and I'm joined by Sean here, who actually invited us out. Sean, thank you so much for reaching out.
Of course.
It's a wonderful show.
How could I not in San Francisco?
Absolutely. And you, as the automation mechanic, are involved heavily when the show is playing.
Absolutely.
So tell me a little bit about what you do as the automation mechanic.
So as the automation mechanic, I maintain the machinery and operate the machinery that everyone rides on the show, whether it be stage automation, acrobatic, flying them through the space. That all comes down to the automation team. We have several operators who run the show. It's heavily involved with artistic to get a great relationship with them and to make some cool spectacles.
So the structure that we're in right now, right? Looks like there's a lot going on. We're under this big tent, 2,000 people plus can fit in here. And is it all really just supported by these four masts?
Yep, welcome to the big top, as we call it. It's the super old school technique of four masts, as you said. We call it like a stick shift, 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's all that supports the tent itself, including the structure above us. Everything lives within the tent, everything is supported by the tent, and it comes with us to every city we go to. We take it down, and we put it back up. It's all temporary, but everything comes back to the tent. Everyone respects the tent. It's the most important part of the show, essentially.
And it's literally the load-bearing aspect
exactly.
of the show. And what it's holding up are the artists and structures like, that's a bridge.
Yep,
right
that's an over 2,000-pound bridge that we fly up and down, the artists fly to. We got a couple of artists that jump off of it. It's a great effect in the show. There's a lot of lighting on it. It looks really cool. We have riggers and technicians in the air that help the artists out. They fly in and out from up there. All the lighting is on the mast. We use this tent to the maximum.
Now, when I think of stage shows and traveling shows with artists like we see in Cirque, I think of like Greatest Showman. You think of people with pulleys and rope. That's not what happens in this kind of show, right?
We are in the 21st century. Doing pulleys and ropes is great. That's how every Peter Pan show is ever done. We go a little bit further because we want more consistency. I do a lot of GUI programming, a lot of front-end programming with a specific software to fly them around in a very consistent manner over a long rehearsal process to figure out exactly how they want to fly and to make sure they can do so safely in this space with the confines of having masts and ropes and rigging everywhere. So it's all computer programmed and predetermined.
And we got a glimpse of that when we went over to your control booth, which really is like this, it's like this master control center with displays, touchscreens, like custom made hardware and software.
Yep.
What is it that you're doing during the show?
During the show, on a good day, I have very little to do because everything's timed out. I have a stage manager giving me the timing of every single cue. They know the choreography better than anyone. So they're watching their steps, their tricks, their spins, and they know exactly when the next flight has to happen, and I'm triggering it. I am there also as a backup to watch everyone else to make sure everything's going as consistently as possible. And so the nice part is that very few details are left to me during the show. We're just extra set of eyes to make sure that everyone's doing exactly what they need to be doing.
So the fun and interesting part of the job really then is before and after the shows where it's almost like a collaborative experience. You are working with artists because you say automation, so behind the shortcut must be a series of...
A very long series of rehearsals, practice, timing, running the same move over and over and over again. The artists have to go through very strenuous rehearsal processes to make sure that each move is as they want it. And throughout the week, when you see us in the shows, they have the consistent act with the lights, everything's going on. During the day, it's just like this. Work lights are on, we have the artists on stage, we have coaches with them, and I'm up in the booth, and we're all changing things as things need to be changed. Hopefully, it's good and consistent. I don't have to change anything, make my life easy. But artists change, they want new tricks, they want to do something different, they want to take off further upstage, or they want to land softer, whatever needs to happen in each space.
So walk me through what that process is like. If an artist comes to you, let's say there's an act that requires, you know, straps, right? With the rope coming down off one of the winches, like they come to you and they say, I want to add a different trick to my part of the act. What do you go into in your software, and what are the actual parameters that you're changing?
So to change anything, regardless of the act, it's always they discuss with us what is wrong with the act, what don't they like, what do they want to change. They're really good at knowing exactly which move. They have a name for it, we have a number for it. We know the relation of those two. They'll come to us, discuss, hey, I'm feeling uncomfortable in this landing, can we adjust the height? I discuss them a little more, okay, is it too early, is it too hard? Well, there's a lot of English to English translation that we have to go through to make sure that we're talking the same language about it. Then we get the coaches and the stage manager involved. I'll prep some different changes up in the booth. I'll have the stage manager on stage with the artist with a headset to talk to me. We'll fly the changes a couple of times, see what they like. Once they like it, I'll hit record, I'll save the cues, and then we'll run a whole series of cues before and after to make sure everything is as they want to be. So that's for every single act, regardless of who it is. We have to test it before it goes on the show and make sure that it's as consistent as we need it to be.
So something that is as simple, or maybe not even as simple, because these are amazing physical feats that they're doing.
There's nothing simple.
But even in a span of 10 seconds that happens on stage, yep, is a series of cues on the strength, the height, and the acceleration of all these things that they're performing with the physical structure.
So my favorite act is actually our Acrolamp act. We have a huge swing that he goes up to 40 feet in the air and comes back down, avoiding the bridge.
Yeah.
That cue is only three simple swings in the air, but has five different cue lines in it to make sure that everything happens exactly when it's supposed to. And it's timed out with the pendulum points and the apex of every single part of it. It's a lot of coordination with the artist as well to make sure that they know the choreography as well, because my timing is fixed. My start timing might change based on other factors, but we all have to make sure we're on the same page of when things are gonna happen.
I had no idea it was that intricate and that in-depth, even for one move like that. And that means that you must have to have like understandings of physics and the performance as well. It's not just the technical aspects of programming these lines.
Back in high school, when you had those math classes of if train A leaves at this time and train B leaves at this time, when will they high five? Replace train with acrobat. And that's what I do. That's the math that I have to do on a daily basis to make sure that everything's happening correctly.
So, okay, you have your control there, but you also have a remote control here.
Yep.
Walk me through what you can do with something like this.
I can control any one of the eight axes we have on the show. So the cube, the turntable, the bridge, any one of the acrobatic winches. Every day we come in and test every piece of equipment just to make sure we know what's going on with it. I can run full cues from here. I'm not gonna run a show from here because I want my full system to monitor from, but I can test everything. I can do custom moves to send things to certain places. If we're doing a rehearsal for the day and I need the bridge into preset it for something, I come in, I go to here. I don't walk up to the booth. I can do every move I need to from here.
Right, and rehearsal makes a lot more sense now, right? When I think these are artists that have been doing the same tricks, or what seem like the same kind of tricks for decades and decades, but they're rehearsing because they're also, every city, it's a new buildup. They're working with you, it sounds like. You must have a notebook of notes that you're making and tweaks you're making.
I keep a notepad in the booth that I write down everything for my own tracking. And once we make any change to any act, we also document it to save, okay, they don't like the change we made anymore. When did we do that? I can go back to those documents and say, okay, it was on this date. I can go to my software, look up that show file, and change it back to what we did.
So even though the show was designed and debuted in 2017, it's constantly evolving.
It is constantly evolving. If you saw this show at the beginning, you aren't seeing the same show here. You, Kishore, and Jeremy all have seen different shows just because of little tweaks we do. Artists taking turns on different acts because everyone will cover different acts together. It's always an evolving show. They're never constant.
And it sounds like it's never boring.
Oh, never boring. Never boring.
So awesome. That's really cool. This is a never-ending walk and talk.